My name is Glenna, and I want to talk to you about Book 2, Chapters 12 to 18 of Little Dorrit. I have loved Charles Dickens and his novels. I guess I don't exactly love him, but I love the novels for a long time, and I had read Little Dorrit before, but I hadn't reread it in a long time. And this time, when I was rereading the assigned chapters, it just hit me like a 2x4 over the head, how much Dickens is speaking to where we are right now. Mr. Myrtle is somebody that is rich without really having accomplished much. He's famous in a way for being famous, like modern celebrities. And people suck up to him. We start this selection of chapters with a social event at Mr. Myrtle's house, and all these people representing various aspects of society are sucking up to the great man. And then there's Mrs. Myrtle, who is also referred to as the bosom, and she's another complete zero that people are projecting onto because she's seen as somebody who's rich and important. And then there are the people in Bleeding Heart Yard, whom we don't spend a lot of time with, but enough to know that they worship Mr. Myrtle, even though they have no realistic chance of ever encountering him or interacting with him. Yet, because he represents something so wonderful, vast riches, they think he's something special. And even the little children are learning their alphabets by M, M, Myrtle, millions. So it's a complete satire of celebrity culture and of worshiping at, shall we say, false gods. And it sounded, I kept thinking, I know Mr. Myrtle, and I wish I didn't know him.